Hello friends, so this is the tutorial for merging execution multiplayer with ALS v4. Let's dive in into it quickly. So first thing we have to disable the camera system. So just go to self tag and remove the ALS character line. And also we need to add the sprint R. And also we need to add a camera. And we just have to adjust. Make sure your control rotation is true. And add some lag. Okay. Let's give it a test. As you can see, I added a mesh for the knife, and all I did is just under construction script, I made two static meshes for the knife, and I attached them to hand right socket and left socket. All right, so now that we have our default sprint arm and camera ready, all we have to do is add our component. It's called execution, and if you go to your folder, excuse me, just go under blueprint and you have an example character. All we have to do is initiate the component. Go back to our ALS. Sorry, didn't copy. Right here. All right, and we just need to the camera boom to this, camera to this. And I already made this variable. It's an object type, and it's set to ALS man, anim man. In your case, you need to set it to your player. Okay. And then we just need an input. I'm gonna do left mouse button. And here, call the component and execute. That's all about it. Compile. Next step, if you go to the component, you have all the variables here. So this is the montage for the victim animation. This is for the attacker. This is the distance, to adjust this distance between the two actors when you play the animation. This, you could check it false if you don't want to execute it on your friendly players. And if you set it to an enemy, then it will fire the execution. Execute from behind. So if you want, by default, the animation of the victim will rotate to your direction at all time. But if you want the animation to play from the back, like you're sneaking on the enemy and taking him from the back, you want to set this to true. This is two variables to have more control on your animation. Sync. Execute damage. This is how much damage you want to apply to the enemy. Delay to apply damage. When do you want to fire the damage? And how far to execute? So you don't need to be too close to the enemy to fire an execution. It depends on your animation. So if you are firing an execution way far, you just need to set the number here. I'll show you an example how this works. The camera settings, you have depth of field f-stop, and also delay to fire the second camera action. this is your default sprint arm socket and the arm length. So you need to set them to your default. So when you finish the execution, you want to go back to your default numbers and values. This variable is very useful. So for example, let's say you have a shooting function and you want to know if you are executing so you don't fire shoot while you are executing. So you use this, for example, want. So if this is true, then you don't want to play something else with it. And what we add, this is the camera one setting. So this is the first camera options. You get the arm offset, the speed for the movement, the arm length, and also the rotation. Same thing here. This is the second camera. It will fire once this is done, and you could play with these numbers as well. So let's prepare our ending montage. So I did get this animations. It's called Dagger, I believe. Marketplace. Let's see. Think it's. Twin Dagger. Daggers. Right here. This is the one. It got some nice executions. And we're gonna give it a try. Alright. So, gonna go to any battle execution. We need. Let's see what we need. We'll see this one here. Yeah. So, this one. We're gonna just retarget, duplicate, but let's find this is the one that's matching it. Retarget, duplicate, and select ALS character. So now we have both of them. These are root motion type animations, so make sure you check enable root motion. This is enable. Also, you need to do the same for the other one. Save all and create montage. Same thing for the other one. All right. So default slot, you could set it to whatever you prefer. So we have to go to ALS mesh and in blueprint and make sure you have a default slot at the end of your graph. All right, save. Go back to our montage. So this is the victim. Go to our execution component and set it up here. Next one, set it up there. Compile, save. The last step is go to your capsule and under collisions, where is it? Right here. Make sure you set camera to block. Save. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna test our guy here. Give it a try. All right, so with ALS, there is something to do with the, like you see this error. So if you see this error, don't panic. It's just because this is a child of the base character, so we have just to make a parent. just like that. Compile. Alright, so now we can move. And the next step is go to your component. You probably won't need to do this with your blueprint, but for ALS you must do this step. Go to enemy and cast to ALS a new man blueprint and get desired rotation mode or set, sorry, and then BPI rotation mode. All right, so right here the sequence and just connect it to our cast. Alright, let's give it a try. So as you can see, it's all plain. We just have to do a small adjustment to the distance and also the camera. So to do that, you just need to go to ALS, execution, and desire distance right here. For this animation, I believe it's 200. Let's give it a try. And then we have just to set our default values here. For the sprint arm, default value is rotation 90, this is 0, this is 0, and sprint arm rotation 0, and this is 300. Now to play with the camera settings, the last one I'm gonna make it minus 70, and this is 20. Let's give it a try. You can play with these variables to get your desired look. Perfect, as you can see. Alright. We could play with more numbers here. 0. Let's try this. Good. That's good. Alright, so now let me show you what we discussed before about how far the distance. So right now you can execute only if you are within this distance. So let's say we're gonna go 4000, for example. So you guys can see what's happened exactly. As you can see, there's a quite a distance, but we're still gonna be able to get him in. And it doesn't matter the rotation of your enemy or moving actors. And you can choose as long as you're facing the enemy you want. Alright, I hope you guys like this tutorial, and hopefully the asset available on the marketplace soon. I'll be adding more updates and more tutorials to make this AAA code for your project. Thank you for watching.